Hello, bonjour, and welcome to the new DITC Social live on Facebook, Twitch, and YouTube. I am so glad to have you join me this evening. Salut, welcome to the new studio. So it's a lot different than what it looked like when Ms. Horizon was here, but Andre's here now. And tonight you're going to get to see a cool little documentary that was made by a University of Quebec student a couple of years ago, which will show the transition that Andre goes to becoming Miss Horizon. So with that being said, bear with me this evening. I'm still working out a few little aspects of my teleprompter, which I'm getting a new one the next couple of days. But I look forward to sharing the stories and having some fun. We're going to have some cooking coming up in a couple of segments, in a couple of episodes. Lots of conversations, lots of fun chat, hot topics, et toutes sortes de choses. Nous allons essayer de faire ça aussi bien qu'on peut. Je travaille beaucoup sur mon français. Je travaille avec beaucoup des employés qui aiment parler le français. Fait que c'est bon. Ça m'encourage puis ça me garde en parlant français. Tonight we'll be discussing some hot topics, but keeping them light and fluffy, and taking some of your questions. So feel free to comment on whatever platform you're on, and we'll bring you into the conversation. Ce soir, nous discuterons des certains sujets, mais les garder légers et amusants en répondant à certaines de vos questions. N'hésitez pas de faire part avec vos commentaires. Que ce soit la plateforme sur laquelle que vous vous trouvez. Ils nous feront participer à la conversation. So, before I get going, I'd like to pay some respect to the Algonquin people who are on the traditional, who are the traditional guardians of this land. We acknowledge their strong standing relationship with this territory, which remains unceded. We pay respect to all Indigenous people in this region, for all nations across Canada who call Ottawa home. We acknowledge their traditional knowledge keepers, both young and old, and we honor their courageous leaders, past, present, and future. Nous rendrons hommage au peuple algonquin, gardien traditionnel de cette terre. Nous reconnaissons le lien sacré de longue date l'unissant à ce territoire qui demeure non cédé. Nous regardons également hommage à tous les peuples autochtones qui habitent Ottawa, qu'ils soient de la région ou d'ailleurs au Canada. Nous reconnaissons les gardiens de savoir traditionnels, jeunes et âgés. Nous honorons aussi les courageux dirigeants d'hier, aujourd'hui et demain. I want to preface this conversation by stating that this is a safe space and that our conversation today is based on mutual respect, openness and understanding. Je tiens à préciser que nous sommes dans un contexte sécuritaire et que la conversation d'aujourd'hui fait que ce soit d'être imprendre de respect mutuel, d'ouverture et de compréhension. So with that being said, I ended up hearing that at one of the meetings that I had at work, and I liked it and it touched me. And we know so many people across this great land, and we owe a lot to Mother Earth. And with everything going on right now, we need a little spiritual healing. So October is Disability Employment Awareness Month and LGBTQ2+ History Month. Each show, I'm going to provide you a few did you know. Le mois d'octobre est le mois de sensibilisation à l'emploi des personnes handicapées et le mois d'histoire LGBTQ2+. Et chaque émission, je vais vous fournir des Le savez-vous. Launching the first Did You Know, la première Le savez-vous, Disability Employment Awareness Month. A large number of working age Canadians have some sort of disability, and the definition of disability in Canada is broad, including physical, non-physical, visible and non-visible disabilities of all kinds, including diabetes, epilepsy, partial hearing loss, chronic pain, depression. People with these disabilities are far more likely to be unemployed than the rest of the population because of the barriers they face, and that most of the time their barriers are not physical. Barriers can be attitudinal, systematic, policy-driven, or a result of unintentional discrimination, and it's a lot easier to address these barriers that we can see, hear, or touch. I'm just going to switch over. Oh, I'm seeing some comments. Might as well get a couple of you guys up. Sorry about that. Hey, Miss Lillian. And as I said, this is new. I'm working with a few things. I haven't used this program since I did my Pride Week. Jason Noel, LGBT in the city. Bonjour, Minou. Comment ça va? De Montréal. Oh, my God. This is great. Right. So these barriers, which many of us are not even aware of, can at times seem impenetrable to a job seeker who happens to have a disability. Now, you'll notice I keep looking up. It's because I have my computer screen, which is big on the screen. I've ordered a little teleprompter, which my camera will be right behind for the next show. So we're working on it. We're working on it. We're going to have some fun. All right. So LGBTQ2+ History Month. Human rights don't discriminate. LGBTQ2+ rights are human rights. A person's sexual orientation or gender identity can lead to discrimination, violence, imprisonment, torture, or even execution. And these abuses are all illegal under the international human rights law. Amnesty International works to protect the rights of lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender, queer, and two-spirited people by shining a light on the rights, on the right abuses, calling for a policy change and a working to protect the LGBTQ2+ human rights defenders. Amnesty International considers anyone imprisoned solely by cause of homosexuality to be prisoners of consequence who should immediately and unconditionally be released. This is the source of Amnesty International site. So now you know. Now you know. What's Francois saying? Yes, I'd love to have you on with the trans and intersex community. That would be wonderful. That would be great. So this past summer, back in August, DiversityCapital.tv, along with Karma Creative Solutions, Beachwood Cemeteries, QueerSphere Expo, and BlastTheRadio.com, hosted a virtual community day where we got to film at the iconic Beachwood Cemetery Gardens. Here is a clip of some of the poems that were featured during the six-hour broadcast. You can see me, the entire broadcast on the Diversity in the Capital YouTube page, which was from 12 p.m. to 6 p.m. But this is a little clip that I made for Beachwood from that. It features the beautiful gardens that you can, just because we're confined to a home, it doesn't mean we're confined to not go out for little walks. Put your mask on, go have a walk, and go check out Beachwood Cemetery. It's absolutely stunning and beautiful. I don't know what else to say, but I'm going to share this video now. You are going to love this. Share audio. I got to remember that. Here we go. I hope you enjoy. Well, and there we have it. So, little technical difficulties that I'm still going to be working out. There's always little hiccups here and there. Is there a way to turn on the sound? The sound was supposed to be on for the video. So if the sound didn't work, oh yeah, the sound didn't work. Oh. Well, that's just wonderful because I did hit the share audio and all right. Let's try it again. We've got time. Right? Is anybody hearing the sound? François, t'entends la musique là?
Thank God for humans in this world.
Just back to you, Jason.
Pink and girls can like blue. Your reaction is up to you. When someone's proud, let them be them. Let boys be girls. Let girls be men. Don't hate because they're different, and that's still up to you. In fact, you should be proud of them because they came out to you.
I won't pretend that I could ever possibly understand what it must feel like to be born in a body that you know just doesn't belong to who you are. But I do understand exactly what it feels like to be hated for nothing more than being who I know I am. And I will always be on your side.
Heart of the storm, stare these words down. You as you stand here right now, changing like a storm over the ocean. Electricity and magic making Harris stand on end. You are loved and powerful and miraculous. Thunder may be low, but be brave, be patient. Count the moment until lightning, and you'll see what is already obvious to so many, that you transitioning amongst waves are cherished and adored and loved by the endless rolling seas, by those around you, some you'll know, some you won't, and by those coming to you, deep breath, you needn't be scared of the dark. Thunder roars, but heavy rains will wash the darkness away.
And here is a stunning view of Beechwood Cemeteries in Ottawa, Ontario, at the end, Saint-Laurent-ish area. Beautiful, peaceful walk. Enjoy. Wow. So, while all that happened, my power went out in the room. So I guess I jumped a breaker or something, possibly with my speaker. So I'm trying to get it back on. One moment, please. I don't know if it's the... It is the breaker that I jumped. Oh, crap. Well, that's wonderful. Absolutely stunning. So my power just went out, and I've jumped the electricity in my room because it's not used to so much equipment and lighting. And yeah, so I kind of I'm going to play the other video. I hope you can still hear. I hope you can still see what's going on. I got Facebook on, so I can see that it's still working. I'm going to run and get cancel. So here, I'm going to turn the power back on, but I'm going to start the Horizon documentary, which is a few moments. And it wouldn't be a great show without some technical difficulties. So, hold on. Okay. Share audio application. There it is. And here we go. God damn it. Damn it.
No. We use it on the weekend, so it might be in the front.
And everybody left. Well, that's great. So that was what happens with technical difficulties. I don't know what is wrong with my camera. Could be just my camera itself. There we go. So I hope everybody got to hear that. Hello, thanks, Lillian. Yes, I'm gonna have to work through some of these little speed bumps.
That's why. Because I don't have my teleprompter anymore.
Oh, Pifa, shall we sit? Wow, this is so much fun. So this is why we have your first one. This is why you learn with the hiccups. Oh, thank you, my dear. I believe in you too. And it was great to see you this afternoon. It's all good. This will be a good blooper reel for future shows. The poems clip, that was really inspiring. So stay tuned during the upcoming shows because we also will have, so I'm just going to turn this volume off because I've got a huge speaker that's bringing me some sound. But I don't really need sound. I don't need to see, luckily I've got my real office outfit on and I've got pants on. Not like a lot of Zoom meetings that I've seen or I've done. All right, now that we've got that out of the way, now Manonk knows he needs to dumb down his set because the power grid in Findlay Creek cannot handle it. No, it's just my room. I think I jumped the breakers and I went down, and because I'm not the handyman of the house, I couldn't see what was the problem. So I will deal with that a little later on. Wasn't able to hear the second video. So the Horizon video, again, you weren't able to hear that either, the documentary. So that would be why everybody left, because we couldn't hear it. I am sweating like a lot of things. And I have my Game of Thrones mug that my nieces and my sister gave to me. Right, well, maybe we'll try the poem one a little later on, but it's all good because we've got a performance by Horizon later on coming up, and with the one and only Gabby, who is a sweetest little girl who lives not too far and took part of the DITC Pride Day that we did a few weeks ago. So that documentary was about me. I had the honor to be interviewed by a talented student by Geneviève Laforce, where I go from Andre and I turned into Miss Horizon during my shows at the time when I was raising money for Jeunesse Idem at Le Petit Chicago in support of Jeunesse Idem. Il y a quelques années, j'ai eu l'honneur d'être interviewé par une étudiante talentueuse nommée Geneviève Lafosse, où j'ai réalisé un petit documentaire d'André Prou montrant comment que je passe de André à Miss Horizon lors de mes défilés à l'époque au Petit Chicago en soutien à Jeunesse Idem. And I hope you enjoyed it, but you couldn't hear it. So maybe we'll play it again a little bit, but we'll try it another day. So I've got some hot topics that I'm just going to put out there. And these glasses are falling off me because I'm sweating. So The Masked Singer, which is on this evening right after me, which is one of my favorite shows right now. I didn't bring my list up and I haven't publicized it either on who I think they are, because I'm doing like the judges where I listen to their initial performance and then they have to write down their initial guess, and then they get to talk and find out some more clues. So based on the clues that you get to see, there have been some amazing singers, and I think I know who Popcorn is, which was the great debate on Facebook last week with myself and a couple of people who've been following along. And I actually think this singer is from the Cher era, I want to say. And it's so amazing to hear her voice once again. She just came out with a new remix by Cogno, the same one that did the Whitney Houston mix. So if that gives you enough hints, that's who I think it is. What else do we got? We got The Masked Singer every Wednesday at 8 o'clock, right after this show on Fox and CTV. Who is that? Theo Tams, the Canadian idol that I got to interview on DiversityCapital.tv a couple of months ago when he was here in Ottawa doing his National Arts Centre show. He's got a concert October 19th. I've already got my ticket. It's a Zoom event, and it's a private event where you get a Zoom link, and then you get to watch the intimate show. I don't know if there's any VIP tickets left, but if you do purchase a VIP ticket, you get to request a song from Theo for that night. And I'm looking forward to it. I hope you get a general admission ticket and join me to watch this incredible LGBTQ2 activist and idol October 19th. It's a show that you will not want to miss. I was there a couple of months ago, like I said, and we got to spend a couple of hours with him at the Lookout after that and have some cocktails and get to know him. And he's a great man. I went with Danny Marshall, and we cried a lot that night just listening to him, and he brought out so many great emotions. So you're not alone. Listen to music. It's very soothing. It's incredible. When I'm feeling down, which is, you know, the last couple of weeks, couple of months, it's been very difficult for all of us, most of us. So I sing, and that's why every once in a while the beverages that I take help with the singing and get rid of the shaking up the nerves, but I still like to sing. So hopefully you check that out. No Forks Given. The Forkiveness Burger. 25% of the sales go to the Distress Center of Ottawa. The burger is made and inspired by John the Milkman Milky from blasttheradio.com. They are working on getting on the apps, Uber Eats, Skip the Dishes, and DoorDash. So they're located at 2560 Bank Street at the Splash and Dash parking lot. The burger looks simply amazing. I cannot wait to try it. I'm going to get there. But it's been very difficult to go out after I finish work. Work's been a little crazy, but we're all going to get through this, and I'm sure you guys are all having your own things too. And if you haven't listened to BTR, speaking of which, they have a boogie break every morning at 10:30 a.m. to get your blood flowing. How many of you stay motivated all day? How do you stay motivated? What's your thing? Do you listen to music? Do you clean? Do you go for a walk? What is you doing? What is you doing? Let us know in the conversation. We'll pop a few up if there are still some people here. Because it's not all about videos. It's all about chatting, and it's all about enjoying each other's company and having somebody to talk to and a friendly face. And if you don't have to wait till the shows, feel free to reach out to me on the Diversity in the Capital Facebook page, .tv Facebook page, or Andre M. Prue on Facebook, and feel free to reach out. I will make time for everyone and anyone as much as I can. Speaking of time, Jesse and Jenna's Messy Podcast, featuring weird news, highlights, and listener letters. If you want to submit a letter, please email Jesse and Jenna at Jesse and Jenna's Messy Podcast at gmail.com. So we've got Lillian chiming in saying music, walks, love to walk the Rideau Falls Park and downtown areas. Well, I'm in Findlay Creek, as I said, so we've got a really nice little walkabout that we take throughout the creek. There's a beautiful little bridge with, I don't know, I want to say a marsh of types, which is beautiful. The only reason why I haven't been there in a long time is because I find the walkway a little too narrow to get all the way to the end. But I mean, you know, wearing your mask and trying to keeping your hands in your pocket until you get to where you're going, you can still get out and do many things and enjoy a lot of things here in the nation's capital. So, speaking of other things, nous allons virer à Jeunesse IDEM, qui vise à améliorer la qualité des vies des jeunes 14 à 25 ans gays, lesbiennes, bisexuels, transgenres, transsexuels et en questionnement, ainsi que sensibiliser la population de la région de l'Outaouais. Je vais vous lire l'information sur la page Facebook de Jeunesse IDEM qu'ils ont écrit. Fait que les groupes de discussion en ligne de mardi soir changent d'horaire et seront maintenant à partir de 18h30 jusqu'à 20h. Nous tenons de recréer la dynamique de nos soirées à IDEM. Donc, nous faisons les échanges avec les caméras. Marie-Ève et Eric sont à l'animation dans la salle d'IDEM pour mettre un peu d'ambiance. Alors, il y en a deux qui seront à IDEM, puis le restant, vous allez être à la maison. Vous allez être capable de participer, jaser, aider d'autres membres. Si jamais vous avez besoin d'aide, contactez-le. Ces groupes et thématiques sont pour les participants de Jeunesse IDEM de 14 à 25 ans, ayant le goût de prendre une pause pour eux elles-mêmes et d'échanger avec d'autres participants de groupe sur les sujets du jour. C'est un moment pour soi et pour se rencontrer d'autres personnes, malgré la distinction sociale, mais tout nous tenons à continuer d'offrir le soutien et de favoriser la socialisation pour les jeunesses allosexuelles. Je travaille sur plusieurs de mes mots. There's a lot of French words that are tongue twisters, but I'm still working on it. I'm still working on them. Important, le respect et la confidentialité sont de mise et plus de votre présence tout au long de la rencontre. Une fois en ligne dans le groupe de discussion, vous n'êtes pas encore inscrit au groupe de discussion. Veuillez simplement écrire un message privé sur Intervenant Jeunesse IDEM sur Facebook et nous vous ajouterons. Alors, si jamais, facebook.com/jeunesseidem, jeunesse, J-E-U-N-E-S-S-E, idem, I-D-E-M. Check them out. La prochaine sera le 25 octobre avec le terme « Et si? » Ça n'appartenait pas. Alors, you never know. That could be a great event and discussion. Supporting LGBTQ2+ businesses, most are all online, so support your local commerce by going to their site and buying something to give to that special someone, maybe for Christmas or for just because you were thinking of them. Feel free to reach out to a lot of people, that even one or two people that you haven't spoken to in quite a while, to see how they're doing and see if they need anything. I've done it for a couple of days now. I've reached out to a couple of people that I haven't spoken to in a long time. And I've got a couple of friends that are going through a lot of rough times on top of all this, including some people close to me. So all we can do is be there for each other. All we can do is smile, put on a brave face, because we're doing all this for the little ones. And we're doing this for like my three nieces who still need a place and a world to call home in a couple of years. So with that being said, now I'm going to play, which I'm doing pretty good. I'm still probably 20 minutes in advance, which means I could probably try the Horizon documentary again, as well as I've got the Community Day performance that I'm going to end the show with, because we all know that the old face of the book loves to end some music. But just to let you all know that you don't have to watch it on Facebook every night. We are also live on Twitch at diversityinthecapital.tv or at Ms. Horizon. It's one of those two. And also on YouTube at diversityinthecapital.tv. So you don't have to have a Facebook account. If you're seeing this on a friend's account, go to the diversityinthecapital.tv pages, like we are also on Instagram. I've had some, my nieces trying to teach me a few younger platforms, which I see a lot of emojis, which are beautiful and sweet and just exactly what we all need right now. So without being said, I'm going to try the documentary again. So share audio and do this again. All right. Oops. All right. Hopefully it's that. And we'll see if this works. Oh, okay. So hold on. There we go. Hopefully this works. So let me know in the comments if you hear anything. That would be great. And if not, then I've got a lot of work to do next time. So I'm still not hearing any sound. So, hold on. I'm still not hearing any sound. I think it's because. Hold on. There we go.
I'm a female impersonator. My name is Andre Prue, and I'm an administrative assistant for the Real Property Services within the federal government of Canada, and I've been with the federal government since 2009. I started doing drag when I was 18 years old, just graduating high school. In 1996 was my first drag show. So as of today, Horizon is 21 years old, and Andre is 41. I'm a female impersonator, also known as a drag queen. I'm a Celine Dion impersonator, and I also do several other characters. So my process to go from Andre to Horizon is basically a shower where I shave my upper body and then a shave at the sink. And then I basically will start with my foundation and then all the makeup process, which is the eyes, the, you know, the blush, eyelashes, lipstick, liquid liner, you know, all the pretty things that ladies use.
I'm a Gemini, so I've already got two personalities. Plus, I'm a drag queen. I got three. And then depending on who I'm performing, I turn into several.
Bitch, nice girl, party girl.
And you turn into a mean girl.
So Dee Dee Delight, I'd have to say that her and I go back over 21 years. And when I met Dee Dee, he was working in the lower level of the bar that I was, that I did my first drag show in, and he was a male stripper then.
Your what hurts, Dee Dee?
So my last performance was at the Le Petit Chicago, where I had several guests that I've known for many years, Dee Dee Delight and Sydney Chanel, who came to support me, and Jeunesse Idem. They aim to help LGBT youth between 18 and 25 years of age. They will help with any kind of services they require, whether it's getting a job or doing their homework. And in the last year, I've raised over $9,400 for them. She's a very big part of my life, and whenever I'm depressed or anxious or upset, I look forward to my next show. It took my parents a couple of years, but they came back, and I mean, my mom calls me every 20 minutes now, so it eventually, you know, it, I guess it stings at first for some parents to find out that their child is gay. But there's been so much advancement teaching people and communities and awareness to the LGBT community that we're just like you and I, or we're just like everybody else. We all just want to love.
All right. Well, yes. So you got to hear it a little bit, yes, because it was coming directly from the laptop sitting right in front of me and with my new microphone, which captured most of that. But I'm going to try for the last performance. Thank you, Lillian, for the inspiring words. As well as Deb. Hello, Deb. Debbie, sorry. Welcome. Thank you for joining us. And anybody else who ends up joining, Francois was here earlier, Jason Noel from LGBT in the City. Please check out your as much of the community as you can. I know there are still people going out. If you need to go out, please be careful. I mean, I'm still in limbo from chemo treatment, so going out or not is not an option for me. So I'm going to have to pretty much remain home as much as I can, because we still don't know what's happening with that yet. But so to lighten things up, we're going to have a performance from yours truly. Now, I just need to... Why is it doing this? All right, so I need to prepare this. Okay, share screen, share audio. Oh, but once I go to another application, I don't think it lets me, right? No, that's why. Oh, it doesn't share the audio when that happens. All right, well. All right, so here's the video, and I'm going to work on the sound for the next one. Thank you so much for joining. It is 10 to 8. next week, I'm going to have some cooking with Tatiana Romanov. There's going to be several other things. So we'll play this, and then we'll talk for a few after. Wow, that was Ms. Horizon and featuring Gabby. That wasn't the right version that I wanted to play. But I am still learning this program. I really hope that through all that chaos and craziness at the beginning and throughout this last hour, I hope you've had a good day, and I hope I put a smile on your face. I hope you enjoy your evening, the rest of your week. I know I'm sure some of you are still full from turkey. I'm full from a lot of turkey pies, although there was no turkey this year. Our awesome neighbors dropped us off a wonderful pumpkin pie, and I'm the only one in the house that eats it. So I've got lots of pumpkin pie to eat. But next week, we're going to be cooking with Tatiana Romanoff, and I'm going to be doing some pre-recorded videos as well, some clips, which I need to work on and be able to share them with you guys a lot better, guys and gals. But I'm going to attempt at making samosas, which I love and I haven't had in a long time. So cooking is a great way to the heart, and it's a good, I've been cooking every night, most of the nights for my partner and myself, and I love cooking. I put some music on, some nice chill lounge bossa nova kind of jazz music, and then I cook away and clean up the house and play with the little fur babies. So anyways, ladies and gentlemen, thank you, Lillian, for everything, and I look forward to polishing up the show and make it a little better next week. This is our reality, folks. We need to stay home. We need to stay safe. If you want to be a guest on the show, which I'm going to have Lillian from Angelic Empowerment in a couple of weeks, I'm hoping, because we had her here when Horizon did her show on the Horizon show, but that was another time where I was working. I've got myself some really awesome lights, which I think is probably the reason why my power jumped in the bedroom. But I also got to sort this out, because for the United Way campaign this year with work, I'm giving makeup tutorials. Don't ask. They're stretching. They really need people to raise some money. So they asked the colorblind drag queen if they would teach some makeup, which, of course, I accepted. I love doing it. I know some of you used to watch my Facebook Lives before the show, but I'm doing it. I'm doing three sessions on makeup. Two of them will be on me, these two. And the middle one is going to be on my beautiful neighbor, Julie, who I'm going to be dazzling up. And it's going to be classy, yet going out or maybe having dinner at home with your significant other, and just to make yourself feel excellent and beautiful and worthy. So yes, well, whenever that makeup tip happens, I will probably end up recording it, or I will talk to the department that I work for and possibly be able to share it after that on one of these shows. So thank you all for watching. It is 7:57. I am on a countdown for The Masked Singer. If you have not watched it, you don't know what you're missing. Who is that? All right, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much. Merci d'être ici ce soir. Thank you for coming. And we will see you next week.